In our previous example, we found the voltage at some point on the line as a function of time. Now what we are going to find is the voltage on the whole line, the voltage on the whole line at some time. So what we're going to do now is specify a particular time. This time is tau, 2 tau, 3 tau, and so on. Let's suppose that I am interested in finding the voltage on the whole line at the time 2.5 tau. So let me do what I did before. I drew a dashed line at the point I was interested in, so I'm going to draw a dashed line at the point of time I am interested in, which is right here, 2.5 tau. That's the time that I would like to see. And then I'm going to draw my line, because I need to know the voltage on the whole line from z equals 0 to z equals L at that time of interest. So what I'm going to do now is find the intersection right there, and I'm going to draw a dashed line representing that interface. And then I'm going to do something I call squash the can. On the left side of this dashed line, that's over here, I'm going to consider all of the voltages that have been received at that section of line as a function of time. So what's that going to be? That's going to be V1 plus and V1 minus and V2 plus. V2 minus hasn't gotten over here on the left yet. So the voltage that I will have on this part of the line is going to be V1 plus plus V1 minus plus V2 plus. Just go get those numbers and add them up. On this side of the line, the voltages that I have, the right side, I have V1 plus, I have V1 minus, but V2 plus hasn't gotten here yet. See, it just stopped right there at the center. So this value is going to be V1 plus plus V1 minus. Now I don't know which one's going to be higher unless I go and look at my exact numbers. It depends on which ones are positive and which ones are negative. So the voltage that I'm going to see is this combination of voltages on the left side of my line and this combination of voltages on the right side of my line. Now, can you give me an idea how this is going to change as I move in time? Let's just move up a little bit closer to my 3 tau. What's that going to look like? Well, the junction is going to be right here, so the point that I would bring down would be right at this point. And what we can see is that this V2 plus value is moving a little bit to the right. So then I would end up with this magnitude up until this little point right here. Now I'm not really too particular about being able to calculate the exact location here, because that's just a combination of doing linear lines here, being able to figure that out. But I would like you to be able to draw the basic parameter and be able to sketch this based on your line. Now let's talk about how to go from a voltage bounce diagram to a current bounce diagram. There are really only a couple of differences. In the voltage bounce diagram, we needed to be able to find V1 plus. This was Z0, RG, VG, and we're interested in V1 plus, which we got from the voltage divider. It was VG times Z0 over Z0 plus RG. In the case of the current, we are interested in the current, I1 plus, which is going to be getting onto this transmission line. So I1 plus is going to be VG divided by RG plus Z0. Now the next change was that V1 minus was the reflection coefficient times V1 plus. The opposite thing happens here. I1 minus is minus the reflection coefficient times I1 plus, and where V2 plus was gamma G times V1 minus, I2 plus is minus gamma G times I1 minus. So every time we use a reflection coefficient, it's always the negative of the voltage reflection coefficient. Then you do your diagrams exactly the same and your calculations the same as I have already shown you.